Are you warm enough, Jeffrey?
Yeah, I could use another log on the fire.
That any better?
Much better, yes, thank you.
I'm just going to stand here and toast my testicle.
Testicle, singular, singular.
Singular testicle?
Yes.
One singular sensation. Testicle. Do you know what we should do?
What should we do?
We should go on a road trip.
That would be great.
Where do you want to go?
Oh, let's go to Arizona.
I can't go there.
Oh, the warrant thing, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, where would you like to go?
Canada.
Canada?
Yes.
That'd be great.
Have you ever been to Canada?
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
What's your favorite part?
Oh, the middle part's awesome.
Winnipeg?
Winnipeg.
That's in central Canada.
Yeah, I like Canada. Good people.
Yeah, they're our neighbors.
Yeah, yeah.
They're our neighbors to the north. And who's our neighbors to the south, Jeff?
Mexico.
Mexico.
Yeah.
I think we've all learned something, haven't we, yeah. Already? Already we've learned that we're in a sort of sandwich between Mexico and Canada.
Kind of a sexy sandwich, yeah.
Sort of a three-way.
Yeah, a continental three-way.
Continental three-way. Have you ever had a continental three-way?
Oh, I have.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Yeah. I have to go back and cool my testicle down.
Oh, getting a bit cold.
Yeah, I have to keep it at room temperature.
Got to keep it at knee level.
You know, that does happen as you get older.
Well, that's a real thing.
What, your testicles start getting closer to the ground?
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely. I'm going to get mine a roller skate.
Well, that's a trick. I'd like to see that.
That's my plan for when I get fired off of CBS, is to get a roller skate in my testicle and then firm up my scrotal muscles so that I can actually balance on the roller skate. And the roller skate is on a high wire, and then I will join Cirque du Soleil. And they will, you know, they'll sing that. And I'll be like. And people will go, oh, the testiculo man.
Craig Ferguson and his amazing roller skating testicle.
So it's another one for the stoners tonight then,
yep,
is it?
Yep.
Yeah,
yep.
Yes it is.
Ferguson, sponsored by Mega Red Omega 3 Krill Oil. Big heart health benefits, one small pill. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Let the tie come loose, undo your pants, take off your underpants. Take them off. Oh. Seriously, get them off. Nah, I'm good. It's a great day for one terrific American, the great Wilfred Brimley, who is 79 years old today. Happy birthday, Mr. Brimley. He is... He's a Libra, of course, but you could probably tell that by his natural charm. But you don't get him a birthday cake. Do not get Wilfred Brimley a birthday cake. Why not, Jeff?
Diabetes.
What should you do about your blood sugar?
Check it often.
Do you know, have you got one of the new iPhones?
Oh, hell yeah.
I've got one too, right? And they say that the new iPhone, you can open the fingerprint lock using your penis. I'm like, whoa, when I tried that, the only thing that happened, I get kicked out of the Apple store. It was a joke. I did a joke there, and instead of doing a joke noise, they did a dun-dun.
Yeah.
Wait. Back there, the director, Francis Ford Coppola. That's who's directing this show. Not the one, another one.
There's two of them,
yeah. Anyway, there's a Bill Clinton story.
Oh, all right, got to hear this.
All right, then. So this is when I get to do my Bill Clinton.
Yeah, this will be good, yeah.
That's right. Bill Clinton says that his daughter Chelsea would make a great president. And I'm like, I imagine that, having Bill Clinton's DNA in the Oval Office. What? Actually, I think it's still there.
Yeah.
Unless they've got that special carpet shampoo. It's really dirty, the show tonight,
isn't
it?
Some of that early 90s stuff, that's good. No, it's good.
Man, you're shaming me. You're not a sidekick, you're a heckler.
No, man. We're trying to compete with Arsenio, it's okay.
Dude, knock it off, man. Just knock that right off, right now.
Early 90s stuff.
It's a very exciting weekend for me. It's the It's the seizure finale of Breaking Bad.
Yeah,
I think I'm having a seizure finale. Yeah. No, I was going to say it's the series finale, and then I went, so I think it might be the seizure finale of Breaking Bad. Bryan Cranston, who was on the show, he told me what happens. I promised I wouldn't tell anyone, so I'll just tell you. If you don't want to know, turn the volume down. In the final scene, Walt and Jesse go into the desert, and Voldemort is defeated. And what else, Jeff?
Bruce Willis was dead the entire time.
He was dead the whole time. He was dead the whole time. And you know what else?
What's that?
It was really a dude.
You're kidding me.
Yeah, that the one that he was protecting?
Yeah.
It was really a dude.
The dude.
Yeah. If you still get the volume down, don't bother turning it up. Go and do something else. Anyway, Breaking Bad, the show is about meth. I've heard people say any show on TV it's about drugs is glamorizes the drug, which is nonsense. Breaking Bad does not make me want to do meth. Look what happens when you do meth. I don't want to do that. It doesn't make me want to do meth any more than watching The Sopranos made me want to be a mobster. Actually, that did a little bit.
Yeah.
A little bit?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. How you doing over there?
You take your pants off. Watch the show. Take your pants off.
Yeah, take your pants off. Yeah. I'm being a Jay Leno mobster
right
now.
Yeah, Jay Leno mobster, yeah.
Yeah, how you doing?
Breaking Bad takes place in Albuquerque. I've been there many times. I got my mug from Albuquerque Rattlesnake Museum. I mean my coffee mug, not this mug. This mug I got from a lifetime of substance abuse and self-loathing. That's what I got there. You know who's from Albuquerque? Neil Patrick Harris. Now, my rattlesnake mug and Neil Patrick Harris, very different, of course. One's something I put in my mouth every day. Who the f*** do you think you are? Some kind of disapproving dinosaur coming out. I wish last night's audience were here. They were awesome.
Yeah, they were better. Judgmental. Jews.
Judgmental. That's it. I'm done. They put
That's
me
it.
Off. Yes, yeah. I'm not even doing any more now.
Well, you did well. That was pretty good. I
did well? Did I?
You did well. You did
Thanks
well.
Very much. Out of 10.
Oh, I'd give it a 7.
That's very generous.
Yeah, that's pretty good. For this show, that's very good.
Want to go to a commercial break?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Down you go, then.
All right. Tonight's program is brought to you by the all-new... It may be a bit premature to re-release it.
Say there is an air of tension here tonight.
Yeah.
Tension
yeah.
building. Build. Do we have any music for building tension? We're very worried. Our first guest tonight, Julia Louis-Dreyfus, is stuck in traffic. She may not get here in time.
What the hell? Are they mixing up there?
Yeah, I think they are actually. Yeah, they're going completely Fat Boy Slim up there. They're like.
Getting a little creative.
Yeah, yeah. Knock that
Crikey.
Off. No, she's stuck in traffic. I don't know if she's going to get here. I'll say it again. She is stuck in traffic. I don't know if she's going to get here.
Say it the second time. She is stuck in traffic. I don't know if she's going to get here.
Well, she apparently is in a car on the Autobahn.
Fun, fun, fun.
Of the Autobahn?
Yeah.
We are the robots.
I'm the operator of my pocket calculator.
She's a model and she's looking good.
Did we do the robots one already?
Yeah, we did it, yeah. So I win the game of Kraftwerk. What we do is we play a game of Kraftwerk.
Yes, that's right.
The seminal electronica band from Germany. I say a Kraftwerk song. Jeff says, what's your name, Jeff?
Jeff
says a Kraftwerk song. And we go back and forward until I win.
And you are, I'm Klaus, or you're Klaus.
Well, who are you then?
Hermann.
Okay, let's begin. I am Klaus.
Hello, Klaus, I am Hermann.
Good, that works out pretty yeah. well. What time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from the great Gonadini.
I like it. Yeah, the great Gonadini. Yeah, with my roller skating testicle.
Yeah,
that'd be great.
Yeah.
Great Gonadini.
That's it.
That's the one.
Yeah, that's
it.
Yeah, that's
it. I gotta call my agent. Hold on.
All right.
Hello?
Yeah. Yeah, hello?
Hello?
Yeah.
I got an idea for the act.
All right, go ahead.
The great Gonadini.
My God, I love it. It's brilliant. It's marvelous. You're a genius.
Great. So when can I expect the check?
I'm still here.
Yeah. All right. What time is it, everybody? Oh, yeah, it's late night time. All right. All right. Shall we play a jingle or just do it?
Yeah, just do it.
All right, then. You ready?
Yeah.
Time for an email. All right, this is from Henry in Kahawa, in Kauai, in Hawaii.
Oh, great.
Yes, yeah. Malahaka Hoke. He says, Craig, what kind... I don't know if you can tell, actually, but he's an owl.
Who?
Henry says, what kind of wax does Jeff use on his skull? What kind of wax do you use?
Oh, I use pomade, man.
Pomade.
Yeah.
This is from Annabelle in Pickens, South Carolina. Pickens, South Carolina.
Ding dong.
Hold it low, dong.
Ding dong.
Finish.
Hold it low, dong.
Ding dong.
Hold it low, dong.
Ding dong.
Hold it low.
Ding dong.
Ding dong. Ding. All right. Dear Craig and Jeff, does Secretariat trot or canter? Trot or canter? Trot. And canter? You never canter, but you like to trot. You don't like to trot, but you like to canter. You never canter, but if you did, you would trot. This is from Lawrence in Dover in Delaware, who says, Craig, you guys make fun out of Dover so much, but it's a great place if you actually would come visit. I've never even heard of it.
Well, you never been to Dover?
Oh, yeah. I think I've been to Dover once.
Yeah.
I've been to Dover once in the 1980s.
Is that right?
Yeah, I wanted to see what it was like.
And that's how the great Gonadini was born.
Yeah. I wanted to see what it was like.
So, check it out, yeah.
Yeah, so that's why I bend it over.
Sure.
This is from Kathy in Chicago. I don't know if you can tell, but Kathy's a great big fat hippo right there. Or she might be a little bird on the top. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. Do you hear that audience just ooh when I said...
Yeah, you know, yeah.
Yeah, she's not really a hippo. Hippos don't type tweets and stuff. Kathy says, Craig, will you stop throwing your wood on the fire because it's just not safe? Sorry. All right, this is from Carl in Montclair, New Jersey. Dear Craig and Jeff, what is the best nightclub in Vegas for a single guy in his early 40s? Oh, man. Dude, stay in Montclair. Come on. Call up that girl you like. Say you're sorry. Doesn't that sound a little sad to you?
Yeah,
a little bit. What's the best nightclub in Vegas for a single guy in his early 40s?
I'm so depressed right now.
Yeah, man. I'm like, I was that guy.
Go to the Sapphire.
The Sapphire.
Yeah.
Did they ooh that?
Yeah, what the hell, man?
What the hell did you ooh that for?
That is a proper gentleman's club.
Yeah, that's a gentleman's club. And it's This is from David in Connaught in New York. Hey, you gonna beep that? It's a real name of a town, Connaught. And there's David, and he's a duck, and that rhymes with
ooh la la, ooh la la.
You are a racist. A Scottish expression. My people use that expression, man. You are a racist. My tie was on the table there like that.
I saw that. Yeah.
It was like it was trying to escape. It's like the audience. David says, Craig, what is the name of that catfish diner you like so much? I'm traveling the south soon. It was the Ozark Diner in Ozark, Arkansas.
Ozark.
Yeah, it's a great place. The catfish there is sensational. You ever been there?
Good eating, yeah.
It's a little town. Called Ozark. It's in the Ozarks.
Right.
And there's a diner there, and it's called the Ozark Diner, and you can get catfish there.
Yeah, very good catfish.
How do you know? You weren't with me.
I own the place.
So what we're doing now is insider trading.
Yeah, man.
This is from Albert, whose hometown is obscured. Oh. Albert walks the earth. Solving crimes.
Yeah, he's part of no clan.
He doesn't want to be in your gang. He's Albert.
Oh, man.
He's Albert. Now, see, that is such the go-to noise.
Yeah, man.
He's Albert.
Wow. Yeah.
I like that one. Not that mysterious, though. Let's try it one more time. He's Albert. Albert, with no fixed abode, says, Dear Craig and Jeff, it seems like you guys have such a good time that you never have any quiet moments anymore. Are you finished with those? Absolutely not. Let's have one now. Hang on a minute. Let's do a sexy quiet moment instead. tonight is an Emmy Award-winning actress. She's a fantastic star. She braved traffic to be here this evening. Yeah. She's starring in the new film Enough Said, which is in theatres now. Take a look at this. Julia Louis-Dreyfus, everybody. Sensational.
Thank you so much. That wasn't stressful getting here at all.
What happened? Were you on the 405?
You can blame Jay Leno.
I'm happy to. What did he do? Was he like...
Uh-huh.
And then...
on that couch for a long time. Anyway, now I'm here. I'm so happy to be here.
Yes, relax. It's fine. Everything's great. You look sensational.
Thank you.
You smell delicious.
Thank you. Why aren't we in Italy?
Oh, yeah, the last time you were here, I said, let's do the show over in Italy. And you said, great, I'll come. And then I said, let's go to Iceland. And you said, I don't want to go to Iceland.
That's right.
Yeah.
And now here we are.
Yeah.
What's up with that?
Well, I want to go to Italy. Do you want to go to Italy?
Yeah, well, yeah.
Okay, well, we're going to need some money.
Don't look at me.
Come on. You didn't take us to Italy.
Sure, fine. I'll pay for it. I'll pay for the whole thing.
What were you doing over at Jay's? Were you... you're doing the talk show circuit, of course. This is a talk show as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You all right? You feel okay?
Ooh, I like when you do that. Do it again. Do it again. Daddy likes that. That's my false knee, though.
I know. It felt weird.
Yeah, it's titanium.
Yes. Yeah, that's very odd.
That one go through. Did that creep you out a little
bit? Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit, yeah, I know. How are you doing otherwise? You all right? You
keeping
busy?
Yeah, I'm fine, yeah.
The movie looks fantastic, by the way, and the late, great James Gandolfini, of course.
I know, yeah. And he's so good in this movie, you have no idea.
Yeah, well, he's pretty good in everything I've ever seen him in.
No, so. I know, but you know, it's funny because everybody thinks of him as Tony Soprano.
Of course,
right? But the thing is that he's so not Tony Soprano. I mean, in real life, this guy was very generous, kind, dear, thoughtful, really self-effacing person. It's very similar to the character he plays in the movie.
Right.
Yeah, no kidding.
It's such a sad thing.
It is a sad thing.
And the movie comes out now. It's out now.
Yeah, it opens wide this weekend. And but it's nice. It's something to celebrate because it's a real triumph for him, this particular
role. It's something to leave behind, I guess. That was that. Yeah.
Yes.
And how are things going over at Veep? You still cussing like crazy over there?
Like crazy.
Man, you cuss too much. I said, uh-oh, here once, and everyone went crazy.
Yeah, I say so many things worse than
uh-oh.
You've no idea.
There's hardly anything worse than uh-oh.
Oh, yes, there is.
Oh, you mean that one?
Yes.
You don't say that one.
I do indeed.
Do you really?
I do.
I expect from you the word sounds positively delightful.
Delicious.
Yeah, well, you see, in Britain, that word's not that bad.
No, that word's not that bad, but there's another one that is also pretty bad.
I don't follow.
Come on, think.
All right, clitoris? You're welcome, ladies. Yeah. There's quite a lot of guys up there going, I have no idea what they're talking about right now. Is that the thing Harry Potter turns into when he's frightened?
That's not the kind of guy for me. Let's just put it that way.
Well, things anyway in New York. Are things all right? You still enjoying the...
In New York? Yeah. What are you talking about?
Oh, you're there sometimes, aren't you?
Well...
Don't you shoot the Veep thing there?
No, I don't shoot it there. I live here, and I shoot in Washington, D.C.
Well, that's what I meant, D.C. How's D.C.? Is it good? I researched the...
Crikey, you know.
I know. And you're drinking out of a snake mug.
Yeah, that's right, because I'm part Viking.
What do I get this?
Well, that's mauve. You got yourself a mauve cup. Is that mauve or teal?
No, it's neither.
What is it then?
It's gray.
I'm colorblind.
No,
I think the comedian later on is going to talk about that.
All right.
What makes you think I'm colorblind? Because I'm not colorblind.
I know you're colorblind.
I'm not colorblind. I'm an FAA registered pilot. I can't be colorblind.
License, please.
It's in my wallet.
No, it's being revoked right now because you can't see anything.
I can. I can see things. I can see you in that beautiful purple dress. With your lovely blonde hair. It's really nice to see you.
It's so nice to
Gosh,
see you.
Gosh, you're pretty, aren't you?
Thank you so much.
It kind of goes away when you do that. Do that again.
Thank you so much.
You might want to think about that.
All right, I will. Yeah. I will. What else? What else is going on in your...
Well, I don't know. How's Leno doing? Is he all right? Taking it okay? I mean, he's still...
Yeah, he seems to be fine.
Yeah, he's kind of resigned to it. When I spoke to him, he's like...
That's a great impression.
I know.
It is
I did
good.
That when he was here, and he went, that's nothing like me. I went, oh, really? You really? Ask anyone else. I think it's like him.
Yeah, it does sound a lot like That's my favorite, is that you don't do words. I can't.
Are you sure you can do it?
Just no, absolutely can't.
Go like... Yeah, and then go, hey. There you are. That's
it. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And then do the little tie adjustment. Yeah.
Is okay. That good?
That's what Jeff does, the best one of all.
Yeah, you know, it's good. You have Julia Louis Dreyfus. It's good. How you doing?
It's pretty good. It's not bad.
Yeah.
Do you do any other ones?
Any other what?
Impressions.
No.
Why not?
Wait, do I?
Well, did you just smell your finger right in front of me?
No, I'm thinking.
Wait, do I?
No, I didn't do that. I didn't do that.
I just smelled my... You did. You smelled your finger.
Oh, wait. Here. I can do an impression.
Okay.
Let's see if I can do it. This is the witch from The Wizard of Oz.
Oh, I think you just did it earlier on, didn't you? Oh, that's very good. Yeah, very good. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Well, we have to take a commercial break.
Already?
It's not like cable over here. It's not HBO. We actually are television.
Well...
Tootsie Frootsie.
Bad.
Yeah! We'll be right back. Sense, that's why.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. No. Hey.
Oh, are we back?
Yeah.
Oh my God, that was.
So great. Everyone in show business is lovely, aren't they? Hey, congratulations on winning the Emmy I just heard about. Yeah, that's great. Did you have a nice time?
I did have a nice
Gosh,
time.
Gosh, the Emmys are a great time, aren't they?
Particularly if you win, it's awesome.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And my friend Tony Hale won, who plays Gary on Veep, so the two of us both won. It was
so that's
exciting.
a double
it's
trouble.
It's a double. Double
entendre.
Oui, oui, oui.
I like when you do that. Do that again.
Oui, oui, oui.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Do that again, and then
Settle
do
down.
Your and then do your and do your Leno thing as well.
No.
Yeah, come on. Come on.
Uh-uh.
Why no. not? All right, smell your finger. All right, that's good. Sorry, I spat a little bit there. I went, and then like that, and I just had some dental work done. I'm in a terrible mess.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, no, it's terrible. I had to have an implant put in.
Where?
My mouth.
Okay, I don't need any more information from you.
Have you ever had serious dental problems?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Root canal?
Yep.
Implants?
No. No, I haven't.
Okay.
I've had crowns and stuff like that. Isn't this riveting, ladies and gentlemen?
They don't care. They just want to go.
Ditto. You got a haircut.
Yeah. Don't try. You're just mean to me. I don't know why you're being mean to me. I'm
no,
your friend.
I'm not.
I'm the one that likes you.
Well, you have
I've said too much.
Uh-oh.
I did get a haircut. Yeah, I just got it done.
It looks very nice.
Thanks. My hair's going a little gray.
All gray.
Oh, no.
You should color it.
No.
I'm kidding. Don't color it.
I don't want to be one of these guys that dyes my hair and then
Please
dyes
don't.
My eyebrows and is going
No, don't do it. There's nothing more, or I should say less attractive than a man coloring his hair. No offense to those of you who are coloring your hair, but I don't care for that.
What about hair that's not here?
What does that mean?
You know, hair in other areas. Can you color it?
Color that hair?
Yeah. Maybe, you know, go different colors, like a little plaid here and... A little deep purple.
But you're colorblind, so you'd never know the difference.
I'm not colorblind. Why are you saying I'm colorblind? You're just attacking me all the time. You want to leave? I'm colorblind. You hate me?
I hate you.
Yeah. I really like it when you're here. It makes me like the job again.
Oh,
I mean, I always like the job, of course. Yeah, it's good.
All right, so what else?
Nothing really.
You've got to be kidding.
No, no. It's Friday night, you know, I'm just chillaxing. Do you ever do that? Put two words together and make them in one word? Chill and relax, chillax.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Yeah.
Or you take some of a word off. For instance, whatev.
Adorbs.
I can't think of another one.
B.
B?
P.
P? What are you saying? What?
I'm such an idiot.
You are.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I was saying penis, so I said P. All right, I'm sorry, let's go back. Va. There, you happy?
Calm down.
Vassa. Vamos.
Vamos, that's what I thought too.
That's what you call an elk's vagina. It's a cross between an elk. It's a cross
what
between.
What is happening right now?
Look, I'm just telling you. It's a cross between an elk and a vagina.
Oh, I thought you meant it was an elk's
vagina. An elk's vagina? It could be that too.
Because I'd like to see a cross of an elk and a vagina.
No.
I don't understand that.
No,
no I wouldn't want to
no,
see
No, you
that.
Wouldn't want to see that. Oh! Dude, what's wrong with you?
What's happening?
No, it's fine. Anyway, look, we're out of time, that's it.
I just have to tell you something. When I was really little, I used to go and hang out at my friend Sheila's house. And on Saturdays, we would actually have mugs like this. We'd put orange juice in it. We'd pretend we're drinking coffee and we were on a talk show.
Oh, yeah?
And that's how I feel. With Sheila just pretending we're on a talk
show. I'm kind of like your friend Sheila.
I know it.
Yeah. That's what I hate about our relationship. I don't want to be Sheila, but I'm Sheila.
Good old Sheila. Those are good times, I'll tell you that much. They were. Just like this is a good time. It's just like we're just hanging.
We are just hanging. We're chillaxing.
Yeah.
We're vamoosing. Yeah. All right, so you want an awkward pause, or you want to talk like a German, or twerk with a horse, anything you want. You want to book a room? I'd like to book a room, please.
What does this mean? Why are you putting this here?
Well, it's a bell, you know, it's just some stuff, because I don't have material.
Oh, I see, yeah. All right. So what am I I don't like any of those choices. Give me another one, sorry.
Awkward pause?
I did that last time I was with you.
Okay.
Something else?
Sure.
What?
What do you want?
Argument? Meh. Is that boring?
No, fake argument is good. We do like to do fake argument.
No, we don't. Seriously, no, we don't.
Okay, fine, fine, we don't.
My God. Oh, my God.
See, you do that thing where you look at somebody who's not there and you get them to be on your side. Oh, there's nobody there. Nobody's there on your side. You're just looking at an invisible person who isn't there, not even invisible.
You need to calm down.
You need to vamoose.
If you're going to be in the Los Angeles area and would like to attend a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, please call 323-570-0059 or visit llstickets.com.
Welcome back, everybody. My next guest is the funniest comedian in the world.
In the universe.
In the universe. No pressure at all. He's at the Comedy Works in Greenwood Village, Colorado, on October the 17th. Please welcome Phil Palisol, everybody. Phil Palisol.
Thank you for that. Thank you. Listen, I appreciate that very much. I hope I look all right, I'll tell you that first off. I never know because I'm colorblind and I can't tell what I'm putting together. So tonight I played it safe and I went blue pants and a green jacket because I know that for a black man like me, when you wear blue pants and a green jacket, nail it. Well, it's good that you're in a good mood, and I hope you're enjoying yourself and at home, too, you know, but it's different for me. You people, you're enjoying a comedy show. Good for you. I'm at work. I'd love to be enjoying a comedy show right now, but I had to work. I didn't always want to be a comedian. I wanted to make it big in porn, but I could never make it big enough. Last real job I had, they had a they put up a suggestion box in the employee area with a big sign above it that said $500 bonus to anybody that comes up with an idea that will save the company money. So I jot down my little idea, and I, well, what if you made the bonus $50? Save $450 on every good idea. Now give me my $500. Not much you can't do in this job. I can't punch a guy. That's about it. And I don't know that I would punch a guy if I could, but I think I'd like to have the ability to punch a guy at work and not get in trouble like a hockey player. Now, doggone it, that guy is at work. He rips the shirt off a coworker, punches him in the face, and he gets to go sit down for 5 minutes. Fight a guy and take a break. I don't know why we don't all adopt that right now, but the league, they don't want him to do it. That's what they tell you. So they find the guy, they hit him heavy, $100,000. The guy makes $12 million a year. He doesn't care about... What if you could go back to work on Monday, punch somebody right in the face for $6? I know. You're the first thing in the morning, Phil. How's it going? In your chin. That's how it's going. Guess I don't have to go to that staff meeting after all. Now do it. I recently dyed my hair bald, and I am not sure... This wasn't plan A. You don't hear a lot of little boys hit their knees at night. Dear Lord, one day let me have face from neck to neck. You don't hear that. A lot of us black guys, when we start to lose our hair, we'll just shave the rest of our head off, which I don't need you either. Power struggle. It wouldn't matter if I was handsome. That's what I really wish. I wish I was ridiculously crazy handsome. Some guys were lucky, man. You know, some guys were born with make love to me good looks. I was not born with make love to me good looks. I was born with ask him. Maybe he knows where it is. Good looks. That's what I got. They're different. This has been a quick shift. Not a lot of busy work in that job, this job. That's the other weird thing about it. You're either doing it or you're not doing it. And there's no off time. See, this is the thing. I ran into a friend of mine who was with a friend of his. And we have a little conversation. They leave. My friend tells his friend that I'm a comedian. He tells my friend that he didn't think I was that funny. It was because I wasn't doing it. That's like meeting a pilot at a dinner party going, I don't know. He was on the ground when I met him. Maybe. Okay, now this is a little awkward for me. I finished my work before I finished my work day. So now I just have to stand here and look busy. That's it. Thank you so very much. This was a real treat. Thank you. Have a great night. Thank you.
Nailed it, man.
What a great treat for me. Thank you so very much.
Nailed it.
Phil Palazzolo, everybody.